All right, whatever, guy. You can save your sob stories for later.
No.
I'm gonna do this from the top. All right. Because this is for a guy who's never even... Well, I don't know. I don't know what he knows and he doesn't know. But we're just going to take it like he doesn't know anything. So, guy basics. I guess we started at normals last time, right? You got a fast jab. It's a four-frame jab. Stand jab, crouch jab, basically the same thing. I think he can crouch to get under stand jab. Hit me with some crouching real fast. Some down. Hit me with some down. So I'm holding the down direction. There, if I need you. Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah. You can crouch under a guy's stand jab, which actually means that you can crouch under his Bushin chain because his Bushin chain has to start with stand jab. So you have to adjust your combos a little bit on crouching opponents, this guy, which is kind of annoying, but whatever. Stand strong. Goes really far. You can stop crouching. It cancels. Even the far one cancels. You can do like the EX shoulder. We don't have infinite meter. Hold on. I got this. Ta-ta. That works. EX shoulders, down back punches. You probably know that. But there it is. It's the only move that's fast enough to combo off of this, I think. You might be able to do Tatsu, actually. And even, actually, you can definitely do run slide. So that works too. I don't think I got it, but I know you can. Yeah, there it is.
Pretty sure you
can. Close strong. It's kind of fast. I think you can link into it, but I don't remember. Yeah, you can. It's the startup. It's the starting hit to a start combo. That's strong fierce. Cancels to anything. Works pretty much like stand fierce by itself, but you know it does more damage. Also has a little bit more scaling, but it's usually still worth going for. And I think you can go into target combo from some other... Oh my god, the lag. From some other stuff. And also, I'm pretty sure far strong combos into target combo. Yeah, that usually works now. It sucked before, but now it's pretty reliable. There's still some characters where it fails. That was pretty cool. Yeah, stand jab, stand fierce link. You probably meant to do Bushin chain, right?
No, I just tried seeing if I could actually do that.
Stand short is an anti-air. It does very little damage. It looks cute, I guess. It's the fastest anti-air he has besides the X flip. So here, jump in on me. If you're not commit, I don't know the timing for this. If you're not committed to anything, oh wow, yeah, only far short works. Close short doesn't. So you got to be really careful about that. This is not his best anti-air by any means, but it does shrink his hurt box, which makes it somewhat reliable. I got counter hit there. I'm just positioning myself to the right place. Don't worry, dude. Guys, jump arc is huge. Anyway, medium kick is actually a really, really good poke. It goes over, like, Shoto low forward. It's got next to no hurtbox and a pretty big hitbox. It goes pretty far. It counterpokes everything. That's really the big selling point. It works a little bit like a slightly worse version of Evil Ryu's stand medium kick, which is a good thing, because Evil Ryu's is incredible. Cool. Stand hard kick. The far one is an anti-air. This is probably his best anti-air, or at least his regular one. It tends to beat things cleanly without trading. Does pretty high damage. Yeah. And the close roundhouse actually works as well. It's not as good as the far roundhouse, but it will still anti-air. So, guy's not completely helpless if he gets the close normal on accident. Stand roundhouse on a close opponent is frame advantage as hell. You can, like, link out of it into stuff. Most people do Bushin chain. That whole combo works though, and it's not even that hard. Stand roundhouse into jabs. Dial the punches. You are a little slow. There's no maximum speed to Bushin chain. You can dial it out as fast as possible. And it'll work. Da 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 da. Okay, there's a maximum speed. I lied. You just gotta find the timing. It's roundhouse. It's hard kick. Ends in hard kick. Oh, it's down and hard kick together. So, yeah, let's talk about his two Bushin chains. Once again, you got to start from a standing normal. But you can combo them from stand jab. Any stand jab. It doesn't even matter if you chained into the stand jab. The Bushin chain still works. So you can do, like that was a chain. Well, that actually might have been a link. Okay, now I'm doubting myself. Maybe you have to link into it. Well, whatever. Let's just assume you have to link into it. But it combos anywhere where stand jab combos. I don't think there's a range. Like, I think if stand jab works, the whole combo will work for the most part. It gets the knockdown. It does pretty decent damage, even considering its 4-hit scaling. It still does, like, quite respectable damage. And actually, mid-screen against most characters, if not all characters, you can pick up an EX shoulder afterwards. It's kinda. It's gonna be kinda hard in this environment. There you go. Dib one. This actually picks up. I think it's a juggle state one at the end. I'm not 100%. I don't think it's a free juggle state. Yeah, this is gonna be the guy tutorial. It's not the guy tutorial, it's just like a really cursory overlook of guy. What are you saying, Dirt?
This is X horizontal afterward. Is that a cancel?
Yeah, no, it's a juggle. It's not canceled. You just gotta time it right. Let me think here. Close versions of normals. Oh yeah, but hold on. So the Bushin Chain in the corner, you can get a little bit of extra damage with different follow-ups. You can still do EX shoulder, but you can do like hard whatever this thing is, and that'll pick up. And you can also do the hard one only hits airborne opponents, by the way. It won't hit grounded opponents at all. So the hard one's four juggles. EX is the fastest, and it's the most damaging too, I believe. It's also invincible. Anyway, you can also pick up an ultra here. It's a little tight and it's laggy, so I'm not gonna get it first try apparently. There you go. Ta ta ta. That's probably his best way of landing Ultra One. I mean, it's not his best, but it's like one that happens all the time. It is corner only. Like, you can't do that mid-screen. It throws way too far. And in emergency scenarios, I wouldn't say it's ever something you can do. You should do. Maybe for style points. But you can FADC the last hit of Bushin Chain and pick up some hits of Ultra, and maybe that'll push them to the corner in time. Like, you can use that to push the opponent to the corner if you're not close enough. Like, if I were just gonna follow up with Ultra, it wouldn't work here. But if I did FADC into Ultra, which I dropped, it would have worked from that range. So that's kind of cool. Like that. That's gonna work. Because I get you in the corner in time. Guy moves pretty far forward for his Ultra. It didn't used to be like that. Anyway, enough about that. The other end of Bushin Chain is the throw. Wait, what?
Can you FADC this way, or is it only corner?
You can FADC anywhere on the screen. And that's a good idea, too, because Bushin Chain is unsafe, so you don't want to just do it. So you can use that to make it safe. A lot of people are looking for punishes and stuff. But in terms of follow-ups you can get, there's only, like, I think you can pick up a couple hits of Tatsu. And, yeah, you can get EX shoulder. Maybe regular Tatsu too, I'm not sure. It's not really worth the bar though. It costs a lot of meter to do something like that. So usually you wouldn't do that. Usually you just pick up the EX shoulder, which you can juggle anyway without the FADC. Gotta do it slower maybe, or perhaps faster. I don't know what your problem is.
Do you FADC after the
Hard kick.
heavy?
The hard kick.
Oh, hard.
So it's the very last hit of the string, you FADC. I think you can FADC any part of it though. Might be a little hard for you. I've been doing FADCs since I was in diapers.
Since you're in diapers.
Yeah. Oh, there it is. Close enough.
Close enough.
So there's the down follow-up as well, which is the throw. And this actually creates a free juggle state, so you can juggle into normals and stuff. But you're usually too far away to juggle into normals unless you're cornered. And there's quite practical ways of landing this actually. It looks a little specific, but actually it happens all the time. But you can cancel that normal into oh god, I got thrown. You can cancel that normal into stuff. And it won't combo, but you can cancel to run and then like get under the opponent or like fake a cross up, stuff like that. Or like juggle into crouch jab and then dash under. That's one I used to use. It's kind of cool looking. Oh jeez. I haven't done this in a while. Yeah, some characters, or maybe it's just timing, I don't know. Hold on. There's ways that you can get under opponents, but it might be character specific, and then you're on the other side and it freaks people out. And you can fake it really easily too, by like dashing at slightly the wrong time. I don't remember how to. I think you have to dash really late. I haven't done it in a long time. Give me like one more try here.
No.
Oh, jeez. Fantastic combo. I think I dashed too early. I don't know. Whatever. They might have taken that out, to be honest. For all I know. I haven't played Guy since Super.
Using light kick?
To cross up? Medium kick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Medium? Yeah. Guy's jump arc is huge, so like it's easy to think that you're going to get a cross up and then you don't. Like, this is probably cross up range. Yeah. I think that's Guy's only cross up. I'm pretty sure light doesn't. Yeah. There might be like a normal I don't know about, but for the most part, medium kick is the cross up. Hard kick is usually what you want to go for damage. I think Fierce does actually the same damage, but whatever. Hard kick is a better hitbox. Yeah, better range. So that's usually what you do. Let me see here. Close normals. I already talked about close strong. It's a little bit faster than far strong. Apart from that, it's just the start of his dark combo. Close Fierce is... It's his highest damage cancel, but you usually use dark combo or Bruisen Chain, so it doesn't matter that much. You don't usually do combos like this, even though it works, because you usually end up doing combos with like links or target combos. You usually do stuff like that. More typical Guy play. Let me see here. That was nice. Good little combo. Close medium kick is frame advantage. You can link out of it. It's not that hard. I think it's 2 frames. So you could do like that. That all comboed. It depends, character dependent, what you can do, but that combo I think works on everyone. Let me see here. Close hard kick is the combo starter. It's his highest damage combo starter, so you do that a lot. You can combo straight into dark combo, which I dropped. Or you can actually combo now into down forward roundhouse, which is I missed it. I think I got it. Yeah. That's his launcher. It actually creates a free juggle state, which is kind of cool. So when you land that, you can pick up... In mid-screen, you can pick up a shoulder, which is alright. And in corners, you can do cooler stuff. People don't use it very often, but it's actually pretty good. Hold on. It's better now that it got sped up. It used to be really, really slow. But you can do, like, ultra when you land that on a cornered opponent. I think I dropped the roundhouse into down forward roundhouse, but it works. You'll have to take my word for it. So that's something you can do. It's pretty good. But the main thing people usually do after close roundhouse is just the Bushin chain. That's cute.
I'm trying to get a... I think it works. Medium into heavy.
Yeah.
Cancel into it, and then I think it's light.
Does that work?
Light
Hazanto? Wait. I've never seen that. That's a hella weird combo. I know you can do jab strong fierce and then combo a crouch light kick, but I don't think that works on all characters.
Yeah, it was like.
There's some weird combos with Guy.
Target combo 2, which is like, I believe it's his medium and heavy, and you cancel that into light Hazanto.
Oh, well, that's. That's just this.
Yeah.
That's a corner only combo. Bushin Senfukyaku.
Oh.
So you do like target combo, which is this one. It's this only target combo. And then you can, in corners, you can pick up Bushin Senfukyaku hits. You have to use the hard or EX, which is good because of the highest damage. You missed several steps. It's strong fierce. Yeah, into down back punch, light punch. So you. Yeah.
I was doing freaking backwards shuriken.
Oh, well, that's gonna make it harder.
Yeah, alright. So.
Come on, Dirt. There it is. There's no FADC in this combo. It's just down back card kick.
And then it's the kick. Is it quarter circle turn? Yeah, it's quarter circle turn now, too. Alright, so that makes it easy. So.
I believe in you. Oh, was that hard?
Wait, is it medium?
It's hard. Oh, it's always hard.
Hard. Oh. So.
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
And you can also pick up EX.
Okay.
And I think mid-screen, you can do... No. And s forget the scenario. But I think you can combo EX shoulder. Oh, you can FADC it to combo EX shoulder. Like that. That's a lot of meter to use, but sometimes that meter's the difference between closing out the round. And I should mention that you can combo the last set of Bushin Chain into super, and you can also combo any successful Hosanto into super. So that looks like this. It's a bit of weird rolling. But that's like your primary way of landing super, and super is pretty good for a guy because you can land it really easily like that.
Was that again?
It's medium punch, hard punch, anti quarter circle back light punch, and then you're going down forward punch for the super. So it's a lot of you got to do a quarter circle back and then double,
Super.
yeah, you got to do a quarter circle back and then two quarter circles forward real quick. Yeah, it's hard,
Wait,
right?
is the Hazanto hard?
No, it's light.
Oh, it's light out.
Yeah.
Alright.
Oh god, dude, no kicks anywhere in this combo.
No.
You can actually juggle into the super in corners, I think. I don't know. You got it.
Like that.
Not bad, not bad. No, I think it's only after Bushin Chain you can juggle into super in corners. And that's actually important on Poison because she falls out of guy's super. Yeah. That gets the same damage.
Oh, so it's like
It's not really any harder or better.
Wait, is that corner only?
Yeah, it's corner only. The cancel works mid-screen though. The cancel you can do anywhere. It's kind of difficult getting the rolling motion so you don't get down hard kick during the last part of that. Because you got to be rolling down forward, but you've got to not. If you get down hard kick, you fuck it up. Supers with punch, dude, yeah. This is kind of hard. This is
Right
a.
into super.
Yeah, this is a semi-hard thing to do. You got to do rolling independently of your button presses, and you've got to be pretty good at. You've got to be pretty good at doing the Bushin Chain. Whatever, dude. We're making a tutorial right now. You can try that some other time. So that's all his standing normals and a few of his special moves thrown in. We'll look at them in a minute. Low Strong used to be his anti-air, but they nerfed it, and now it's just a moderately fast button. It has no anti-air properties whatsoever. I guess it's still useful crouch teching versus Rufus, like because you can hit him out of the air with the dive kicks, because anything will hit those out of the air, and this has got a nice little hitbox. Plus, you can crouch tech while doing it. It's low forward, you can link into it, but it's kind of hard and it's kind of useless. It knocks down, it's two hits. I think it's safe actually if you block it. Come on, dude. Stay on topic. Try that low forward out. Look at that cool knockdown. The link is kind of hard. I think it's one frame or two. I was stand jab into low forward. Yeah. That's low short. Whatever. That's not a very good link, to be honest. Low forward is it's an okay poke. It tends to only get one hit, and you need the second hit in order to get the knockdown, which kind of makes it underwhelming. Oh yeah, low strong is frame advantage enough that you can combo jabs out of it. And actually, you can combo like far strong, but it's one frame. It's quite tight. I can't even seem to get it. Actually, it might be counter hit only. I don't remember. No, I got it. There it is. Let me see here. Low Fierce is. It looks like it would anti-air, but it kind of doesn't. And it forces stand on a crouching opponent, so you can get people into nice standing animations. And that's not really that important for Guy. And it's frame advantage enough that you can combo out of it. So you can do like that into far strong. And that's pretty easy. It's not a very hard link. It's got to be like two or three frames. So you can do that. And then, of course, far strong cancels, so you can do like combos like that. Or like, you know, that's pretty good. Those are useful combos. Oh, watch out. Let's see here. Down roundhouse slides. It's useful sometimes, I guess. It doesn't knock down unless it gets the earlier hits. It can be safe if you space it out nicely, but it won't knock down if it's at safe ranges. So, you know, good with the bad. His low short is his only three-frame button. It's really, really fast. It's actually frame advantage enough to combo out of, but it's slightly harder than his jab. Like you can do crouch short into stand jab, but it's like two frames, I think, or one. Feels like two, I guess. And then you can do crouch jab into stand far strong, and that's one frame. That's a really common bread and butter combo for Guy. That's like what Guy players do. That's hard though. Most guy play. If you want like an easy combo, you would probably do like low short, stand strong, stand fierce.
What's his freaking slide again?
Is run.
Oh, it's heavy.
It's no, it's the run follow up. Run is down forward kick, and then medium kick for the slide. And you've got to do it really fast for a lot of his combos. It's not that hard though. Honestly, it's got a little bit of input leniency, unlike Forte's run, which has like none. That's a hard combo to go for. That's literally a one frame link. You've got to do low short, low short, low short, and then stand strong, and then run slide. I blink it, so it's not that bad. It's hard though. Stand strong is send medium punch, dude. Strong is medium punch. Fierce is hard punch.
I still need to use the translator.
I'm sorry, dude. I just use these words without even thinking about it.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, I don't know what you're talking about.
Anyway, this is one frame link, so let's stop worrying about it. What else? There's some normals I've probably forgotten. Ninja Sickle, Free Juggle State. I already mentioned that
Yeah,
one.
how do you do the backflip stage?
It's down forward hard kick. This is it. Hold down and forward, and then do hard kick. Yeah. And that's a launcher. That's guy's launcher. You can link into it. You can do it after jump-ins and stuff. The damage is all right. Yeah, that's what you do. I don't think there's any other follow-ups mid-screen. But in corners, you can also combo Tatsu. You can combo Tatsu and Ultra One on cornered opponents. That actually works, but you need an FADC. It's kind of a cool combo, but it costs 4 bars, so you'd never do it.
It's fancy.
Yeah, it is
You
fancy.
do it like last second kind of
I've
deal.
killed someone with that, so yeah, it's not useless. This is a normal.
But it's not recommended.
This isn't it's elbow drops down medium punch midair. This is actually probably Sky's best and most unique normal. He's got a what? Derp, I need you. All right, cool. Down medium punch. You can do it off of forward jumps, back jumps, neutral jumps. It kills your. I think it keeps your upward and downward momentum identical, but it kills your lateral momentum. And that's really important because it gives Guy a short jump if he wants one. So, like, maybe, like, it's timeout. Like, let's say you're a Guy player, okay? Let's say you like to anti-air and you do it by doing down back kicks for your EX Bushin Senpukyaku, right? Like, give that a try. I want you to anti-air me, all right? So it's down back kicks.
Okay.
Yeah, you ready?
Yeah,
Oh
I'm
shit, the
waiting for
lag.
the back.
Down back 3 kicks. Or 2 kicks, or fucking however many kicks you want to hit that's not one. This thing.
Oh no.
Quarter circle back. Yeah. So I'm gonna jump in. You ready? Ta-ta. Yeah, beautiful. You did a little early, but like it didn't matter. You got me out of the air. Yeah, that was nice. You can get 4 hits if you're super deep about it. Try me. Jump
But,
it. Jump in hard kick.
Yeah, like.
Oh jeez. It's hard, actually. Maybe 3 is the maximum, I don't
You
remember.
have to be like a good distance, because if you're far away enough, you can, or not.
It goes up pretty high. Guy's got a really weird jump arc, so we're like, it's weird to do it with him.
Well, he's a weird jump arc, and then he has a weird, falling.
That thing's weird too. We'll talk about that thing in a second.
Yeah, they're all weird.
Anyway, but let's pretend you're trying to anti-air me, alright? Do it again. Whoa, watch out, dude. What are you doing? So I'm gonna jump in. I want you to down back kicks me. This thing, are you ready? Are you ready? Here I come.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Whoa! Did you see that? That is literally why Guy's elbow drop is useful. From the same ranges that I jump in, that I would be getting jumping combos on you, I can bait like Shoryukens. I can alter my jump arc, and that's just really useful. How useful it'll be will depend on what character I'm fighting. But like against Sagat or something like that, you can land on a stand hard kick or bait a Shoryuken, which is really good. He has to anti-air you. Yeah. Yeah, he has to anti-air you knowing that you're gonna elbow drop, which he never knows. So that's good. It also tends to win in air-to-air situations. Like if someone jumps in at you and you do elbow drop and they do like some other move, the elbow drop will usually win. So that's nice. And you can combo out of it. It works like a normal jump in. It's kinda hard, you gotta be pretty precise about what you combo into.
Time it just right.
It's easiest to go into jabs, but you can do other stuff too. It'd be hard to do elbow drop into stand hard kick. That would be a difficult combo to land. You really want... Whoa, that combo doesn't work anywhere. You really want... I don't know. You really want to use your elbow drop quite early, realistically. If you do this, if you do, like, that, you might as well not even be elbow dropping, because you're not even changing your jump arc. You might as well just do hard kick, because it does more damage. Elbow drop is only useful for the fact that it changes your arc. One thing about Guy, though, that kind of sucks, elbow drop on me. Give me a little elbow drop action. Is you can low profile elbow drop to fuck around with Guy. So you got to be a little bit careful about elbow drop for that reason. You can't low profile as regular jump ins. Well, you can if Guy doesn't really high. But normally you can't low profile as regular jump ins. So only elbow drop. But there are jump arcs where he can't land regular jump ins. He can only land elbow drop. So he'll obviously be looking for elbow drop in those instances. Other air normals of note. Standard hard kick creates a launch state. It gets two hits. You can't juggle off of it if it gets both hits. But if it gets only one, you can actually combo a EX shoulder. So, let's check this out. Try neutral jumping.
No, hold on, I'll try this.
All right, fine. It's gonna be hard to get one hit only, to be honest. It's easiest when the opponent's jumping in on you. So let's try that. I'm gonna jump in. I want you to neutral jump hard kick. No, just on reaction to me jumping in. You ready? Nice, sick maneuver right there. Look, you just jump in on me, all right? It's like that. Well, I did it too early or too late. Try again. It's kind of hard getting There. Oh no, I still got both hits. I do this sometimes and I get one hit, and when you get one hit, you can EX shoulder. But whatever, it's working pretty well right now, so who cares if it misses one hit. It's a good little anti-air. Neutral jump medium kick is also a good little anti-air. Neutral jump fierce is... It's got a good hitbox for his safe jumps. Apart from that, it's not very notable. Jump strong. I guess it airs pretty well, but I never use it. Jump short doesn't do anything that I'm aware of. Jump jab doesn't do anything that I'm aware of. Is that all his normals? Oh, his overhead. That's the one we're forgetting.
Yeah.
It's two hits. Breaks armor. Just hit me with a focus.
Focus.
Ta-ta. That's what that does.
Let's do it one more time.
You want a red focus. Yeah, it won't break a red focus. So yeah, that's what it's good for. It's alright, it's pretty fast. I tend to use it quite a lot. You can also cancel it before it connects. That's usually useless. But people tend to high block when they see an overhead startup. And this move only hits stand blocking opponents. So you do that, you do the overhead to fake them out into standing, and then you go for the grab. That's like the idea, I guess. You can also use it to do the meaty. Like, if you get a knockdown, you can do, like, the meaty towards strong, and then bait a shoryuken like that, and then you can, like, interrupt their shoryuken with EX Tatsu. That works okay. It's not that great, but it does work. A lot of people don't react in, like, a wake-up situation, because it's too fast. So that's... I don't know. He can cancel it, though. It's just good to know. What?
When you were doing the fake, how do you fake it? You
just cancel it to a special move. It's a special cancel, but it's before the move comes out. So just try doing like a, you know, yeah, exactly. I've swagged out with that before. I've killed someone with that. But that's a thing I used to do when I would like get someone, like I dizzied someone and they had not a whole lot of health left. One thing I would do is this. I would do like that. That costs 2 bars. It's no different from a regular focus attack, but I'd use it to kill people.
Just psych them out of the
focus. Yeah. You can do that with red focus now. And what's funny is red focus, if you cancel it to it like that, it costs 3 bars, but it gets an automatic level 1 crumple. So you can get a level 1 crumple with Guy. It's kind of silly. It's not that useful. Towards strong into level 1 focus. You know what? I just thought of something. It's going to be kind of cool. Oh, no. Juggled. Yeah. Anyway, we're getting heavily sidetracked here. That overhead is okay. Honestly, you should be using it like this. You shouldn't be using the cancel properties. You should just be sticking it out here and there. I'm getting messaged. Let's talk about special moves, because I ran out of normals to talk about. Well, let's talk about his throws really fast. It's really short. Forward throw. You can hold up forward. If you do it against most of the cast, you'll get a perfectly timed cross up. He derp just delayed standing, so it didn't work. Delayed standing throws a wrench in a lot of guys' old setups, but you can react to it, so it's all right. But like if there's no delayed standing, just holding it forward gets a perfectly timed cross up. And what's good about that is if you elbow drop, it's not a cross up. So if you just hold up forward after a guy forward throw, you can get a neat little mix up between left and right that's quite hard to react to.
Can he juggle anything off of his side grab?
His side grab? Oh, no. It looks like his other throw that you can juggle out of, but it doesn't actually juggle. There's no juggling state. You can do setups after back throw too, but there's other ways to time those, and I don't know what they are. Maybe like whiff a low strong or something. Maybe now that there's delayed wake up, you'd probably do like two dashes and then react to the fact that they did delayed wake up or not and then jump or something. I don't know. Dash dash like that. I don't know, dude. I'm not a guy player anymore. Just for the record though, I don't know if it's really considered normals, but guy can jump off walls.
Which is awesome.
Yeah, it is cool. And
Like, what a day.
you can jump really far off of them, but then you can just,
Yeah.
you can just cancel your jump still with down strong. And I do that sometimes, like get back a little bit. Like if someone's looking for anti-air, like out there, and I do like this, and, like their anti-air will whiff. People like see the jump
Yeah,
and
a lot
they're
of
like, "Oh
people
my
try to
god."
do that. I try that. Yeah.
Anyway.
Oh, you can jump off any wall, that's it.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be an actual corner. You can just jump off walls.
Okay.
That's
Just like
true for
off.
all characters. El Fuerte, Chun-Li, everyone who can jump off walls is like that. Vega. You're jumping off nothing. It's kind of weird because you jump off the wall, but then you scroll the screen, there's nothing there. Special moves. Horizonto is sort of the most user-friendly special move guy has. It goes under fireballs. We don't have any fireballs here, so we can't demo that. The hard one is really the one you want to use, and you can't react to a fireball. You have to predict it. You have to expect the fireballs coming and then hard Horizonto. It goes pretty fast though, and pretty far, so it's not that hard. And the medium one you can use too, and it goes even faster than the hard one, but it doesn't go as far. The light one goes under fireballs, but you'll almost never use it to go under fireballs because it's not fast enough. But it's very combo friendly. It comes out really fast. It's safe too. I think it's safe against SPDs now, but you can still get ultra. I think it's minus one. I think Zangief and T-Hawk can still ultra one it.
What were you saying about fireballs
You
and his
can go under them with Horizonto. Horizonto ignores fireballs. During the period where guys like low to the ground, fireballs go through him.
Okay.
So you predict a fireball and you do like that. Let's see here. EX does not go through fireballs at all. It's got no fireball invincibility. I often tried to use it when I was starting out to like go through fireballs and I would just crash into them. I was like, oh, fucking great. It's really fast though. Light and EX are the only ones you can combo into. You used to be able to do stand medium punch into medium Horizonto, but that doesn't work anymore. Try to keep your mind on the topic at hand there.
Sorry.
So light combos after any medium or hard normal, I think. Pretty sure. Maybe not after close forward. Light Horizontos here. Yeah, I don't think that combos. But like after target combo is the most common time. Or after stand fierce. Or after, I think,
That was medium.
far
Yeah,
strong it
that's
doesn't
light.
work either. Get your cancels down. There you go. Far strong it doesn't work either. EX actually comes out faster than light does, so EX will combo even after like far strong. Or like after close forward. I don't think EX combos after jabs though. I think you need at least a medium normal in order for EX to combo. Oh no, that comboed. Well, maybe not crouch short though. Oh jeez. That'll work. No, EX is fast. Wow. EX combos off of lights. What else? That's pretty much everything for Horizonto. You can cancel it to super and you can cancel into it quite easily. It has a lot of corner carry. That's one of the main appeals. Guy has big combo options in corners. So you always want to get as much corner carry as possible with Guy. So that's something I do often is I get the EX shoulder just to push them to the corner and then just do a bunch of dashes to push them and like keep them there. is Bushin Senpu Kyakyu is fairly self-explanatory. It's just down back kick. The light one has no use that I'm aware of. You can use it to combo super in corners after like certain distances, which is okay, but honestly you never do that. Medium combos after lights. If you don't want to go for a hard link, you can just do combos like this.
It just seems like no point to light.
Not that I'm aware of. I don't know what light's for.
Why would you make it if there's no point?
Dude, most special moves, the medium version is useless. Let me see here.
They're just like, fuck it, this will have a use.
Yeah, there's medium's just to bridge the gap between light and hard. Hard doesn't combo at all on airborne opponents, but it anti-airs okay. Honestly, it trades a lot. But it does go pretty far pretty fast. And you can use it to pick up juggle, so it's the juggle-friendly one. And then EX is not only incredibly juggle-friendly and the strongest one, but it's also the fastest, and it's invincible. It's Guy's Reversal. It's invincible for quite a long time. He's invincible till the second spin. It's a really good reversal. You can't FADC it, but it is 4 frames, so it's pretty fast. It's as fast as a flash kick. And I think in the arcade version, they made it 2 frames, which introduced a lot of glitches. It's kind of hilarious, actually. Check this out. A special move doesn't deduct meter on the first frame because you can Kara the special move, like an EX move, and then if you Kara, it won't be like it doesn't. They don't want to take away a bar from you if you only had the move out for 1 frame. So in arcade version, if you killed someone with EX Tatsu, it would hit on the second frame. So it would actually kill someone in the same frame that it was supposed to deduct meter. So if you killed someone with the first hit of it, it wouldn't subtract the meter from it, because it was the only 2-frame move that hit immediately. Like all other 2-frame moves, like SPDs and supers and stuff, would deduct meter, like, you know, during the animation. But like this one didn't have an animation; it would just immediately happen. So there were like a bunch of glitches associated with that, and they ended up reverting it. Guy having a 2-frame reversal was kind of a fucking stupid thing, anyway. EX works as an anti-air. It's all right. It's his most reliable anti-air. It's really fast. It is somewhat vulnerable because it does go straight up, so it is kind of weak to people altering their jump arcs. But there, I got all 4 hits. But Stand Roundhouse you can do for free. Yeah, this is the summer guy out. Dime, I didn't even see you there. It's combo friendly-ish. Like there are times when you can only combo EX Tatsu. Trying to think. Like here. After an EX Susanto in the corner, EX Tatsu is the only thing that picks up in time. So there are times when you're forced to use it, but for the most part you can use it in existing combos and it's okay. It's honestly like you have better options most of the time. I think it might actually fall out at ranges too, so that kind of sucks. Let me think. What else about special moves? What's the next special move? This thing. It's
I forgot how do you do that.
It's just quarter circle forward punch, midair. Yeah, full quarter circle. Make sure you do the whole motion, then the button. There you go.
Wait, does it change depending on what move?
I don't think so. I think all versions are the same. EX is invincible. And I think they actually do
How to say that.
Bushin Hiten Izuna Dos. Or throw. Izuna throw, probably. I don't know, fuck. Anyway, what if you did do an EX Tatsu on wake up. Or not on wake up, but you know, when I get close to you. I'm gonna jump in. So, you ready?
Okay. EX Tatsu.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. I mean, beautiful. Oh shit, hold on, let me try again. I don't even know if this will work. Well, you see how I was. You can use it to be invincible, but even a lot of reversals, like a uppercut, like Shoto uppercuts that are not EX, you can just grab them out of their Shoto uppercuts. Oh, there. So it's got invincibility, and air moves to have invincibility is a pretty big deal. It's also got a pretty big grab box. Like, Guy jumps really high, so it needs to have a big grab box to function. So you can use this on reaction in air-to-air scenarios. It's pretty fast. You probably usually want to use the EX one. And actually, you can anti-air with it. Like, jump in on me. You roll from down to up forward. Yeah, jump in on me. And you roll from down to up forward, And then that gives you a quarter circle forward motion in addition to jumping. So it looks like that. Give it a try. Hold down, down forward, forward, up forward. Like all one smooth motion from down to up forward. It's just an extra long quarter circle. Wait, are you hearing me?
Don't even like know like I jump forward and grab you.
No, 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 that's check. Down, hold down, down forward, right. Forward, up forward. It's like a big quarter circle, right? It's like quarter circle to up forward. And then you hit punches as soon as you leave the ground. You're a little early. You want to do it like that. Well, that's how you do it.
That's weird.
It's pretty good. It's an okay anti-air. It actually might be as high as damage regular anti-air. Whatever. That was too early on your punches. Whatever. I don't care.
Okay.
Let me think here. What's another special move, dude? Run. Alright, he's got run. You can just stop. Honestly, run stop is probably the best option because you can use it for like resets and pressure. It'd be pretty fast. Yeah, like that. Like with counter hits, you actually, it keeps you in. It keeps you, like, it's safe. I think even at worst, it's like minus two. So that's good. I think on counter hits, you can combo out of it. On block, it's minus two. That's what I meant to say. You can use it like that. A lot of people do that. You got to be really fast about your cancels. You can combo to the medium follow-up. You can use it to go under fireballs at certain ranges and hit people's feet. And it's also the only one that's fast enough to go, like, combo. Oh, jeez. Why would you do that? And actually, after a run slide, if you hold up and they don't delayed stand... What?
What? Is it run and slide?
Or yeah, it's run and slide. It's quarter circle forward kick plus medium kick. You'll stop as soon as you hit the opponent, so you gotta hit the medium kick pretty soon. What a lot of people do is just quarter circle forward medium kick and then hit medium kick twice. You should still be able to do it from this range. It's like that. There you go.
There we go.
Okay. But if you hold up immediately after landing that, it'll give you a 4-frame safe jump. Like, safe against 4-frame reversals. What are you doing? That doesn't even cancel. It's strong fierce, dude. What are you doing? Just strong fierce. If you do a jab there, you can only go into Bushin Chain. It doesn't cancel anymore. Oh god, there. Oh god. It's really fast. Medium punch, hard punch, dude. There you go. Into run slide. Yeah, you actually picked it up. But then if you hold forward, hold up. If you hold up, 4-frame safe jump. I actually dropped it. What's going on here? I'm doing a jump fierce. I don't think that works on all characters. Jump forward, I think, works on all characters. But just for an example of cool things you can do, like with guys' safe jump, can you wake up backdashing?
Sure.
So, see that? Option selected a sweep. That's really easy to do. And guy has lots of those. Like, I could do this one too. Hold on, this one's a little harder. Oh shit, that's not what I meant to do. It was cool though. I did the wrong combo without thinking about it. There, like that. Run stop is minus two if you do it perfectly. From what normal? From Stan Fierce? What were you saying, Dirt? You just want to block, ideally. Yeah, and defend yourself properly. But like that's part of the mix-up, too. Ooh, that was cool. That's part of the mix-up, too, because Guy might just do something like this. I tried to land and throw you. Like that. And that's alright, too. And he can land and block as well, and that'll block 3-frame reversals. Like, if you empty jump, you can still block shoryukens, but you have to empty jump. You can't come down with medium kick and still block shoryukens. But, like, if it's Guile and he has flash kick, you can come down and do medium kick. And if he does a flash kick, you can still block the flash kick in time. So it's pretty good.
Dimestar DD says, Baffy, you need to teach him Guy's secret kunai.
I don't have... Yeah, wrong character. Guy, on one of his outfits, has kunai. But, like, Dime knows that that's not a thing. He's joking. What else about run? Oh yeah, delayed standing fucks the whole run thing. I don't know if there's like an adjustment for delayed standing, but I don't know it. But like if you delayed standed, you know how to delayed stand, right? It's just two buttons when you get knocked over.
Okay.
As you hit the ground. As you hit the ground. There you go. Yeah, that screws up the safe jump.
Oh, I
So.
thought the late standing was just not clicking jack shit.
No, that's a normal wake up.
Okay.
So, okay, let me quickly derp. When you get knocked down by a move that causes a soft knockdown, you tap the ground or hit two buttons, whatever you like. Tap down or hit two buttons. And that derp's not even saying anything important. Hold on. I don't know how loud the volume is. Derp, say something.
Hello?
Hey, yeah. How's that chat?
You should be able to hear me.
Derp's talking pretty quiet, honestly, even on my mic. Where was I? Been interrupted. Yeah, when you hit two buttons when you got knocked over on a soft knockdown. All right. So on a soft knockdown, you can quick stand, but you can't delayed stand. And on a hard knockdown, which is like throws, special move, or throws, supers, ultras, and sweeps, cause hard knockdown. And if it's a hard knockdown, you have to hit. You can't do a quick stand, but you can do a delayed standing, and it's the same input. It's just two buttons as you hit the ground. Let me think here. Double-digit viewers at 3 p.m. on a Monday. What the hell? That's not what I meant to go. What special move am I forgetting? Guy has a lot of special moves. Oh, I didn't do the overhead, run overhead. I think I did everything else. Oh, I didn't do his quarter circle forward punch. Hosanto's his armor breaker. It's kind of useless as such, but it would be
Well,
completely useless if it was we'll get to that move in a second. Hold on. That's cute. You can anti-air with that, by the way. Jump in on me. It's not very reliable. It's not very reliable, but it does work. Let me see here. So,
be an ultra grab?
we'll get to that in a second.
Right.
So, hard kick follow
Wait
up.
for that.
There's an overhead. Oh, it's unsafe. The slide is unsafe too, but this is unsafe only if you block it. If it hits, it's safe. So, run then hard kick. Give it a go. That's medium kick, son.
Yeah.
There you go. If you get a second hit only, you can actually, maybe if you get both hits actually, you can pick up a crouch light kick link. It's really tight though, it's one frame.
Jesus, one frame.
Yeah. I don't know the context in which you can land it. I think it has to be a crouching opponent though, which is fine because it's an overhead. The overhead is like -4. If you block it correctly, you can punish it with most of the cast. I think it's -4, it might be like -5 or worse. It also breaks armor by merit of being two hits, which is nice because the other run follow-ups don't break armor. And actually, if you get a mid-air connect, you can get juggles, but usually that doesn't matter. But I've had it matter before. Neutral jump.
Neutral jump.
Yeah.
Okay.
I got both hits still.
What?
I've had this pickup, but and I've reacted to it, but it's not something that happens often. That was cool. Every time you hit buttons, Derpy, you just slow us down.
It just what?
You just slow us down. From the learning.
Sorry.
It's all right. I'm just fucking
Right.
around. No, honestly, like you can attempt whatever you want. I don't care that much. No, anyway, if you get one hit only, you can pick up an EX shoulder or an Ultra One in corners. You can pick up an EX shoulder anywhere or an Ultra One in corners. What else does
Can
got?
you? Yeah, you probably can.
What? EX shoulder? Nah, it's corner only, I think. I could be wrong. I think it's corner only though. Or actually, you might not be able to EX shoulder at all. Don't know. Do not know.
Do not know. All right.
Unimportant right now. Two special moves I forgot. What were they? This thing? Quarter circle forward punch. It's the grounded one. The command jump. It makes a special noise so you can tell it's different from a normal jump. Main use of it is beating up noobs. Honestly,
Beating up dudes, pretty much the best description of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If the opponent's airborne, it anti-airs pretty well with that grab. It's literally just punch to do the grab or the elbow drops. It'll automatically take whichever one works. It'll take priority with the
Do you
grab.
just click a button to grab him, or does it
Yeah,
automatically
it's just
hit?
punch. You hit punch. But you have to be close. Yeah, there you go. And that works on any airborne opponent, it's pretty good. But on standing opponents, on grounded opponents, they have to be standing. And it's quite hard. You have to be basically, behind them. Or, right above them. Like that.
That's a weird animation.
Yeah, right. So if you the thing is, if you if you if the opponent jumps, you're supposed to high block. So a lot of people get that in their head to high block whenever the opponent leaves, the ground. But this move you're actually supposed to low block. So people who don't know the guy matchup, they'll see this and they'll instinctively start high blocking and then guy will just grab them. So it beats up on people who don't know that you're just supposed to hold down back. And actually, you can punish it with down medium kick or any other, not necessarily down medium kick. Low profile normals. Guy has down medium kick as his. We'll punish. Try it out. Do down forward punch on me.
Down forward
The
punch.
core circle forward punch. Same move we were just
Oh.
doing. If I regardless of what you do, I can make you land on a medium kick. Even if you do do the follow up with the elbow, it's just punch. No. Just literally, it's core circle forward punch, then punch again. Elbow drop. Anyway, that's what happens if the opponent isn't throwable, and you still land into the sweep, so or the low profile normal. So basically, a low profile normal will just outright punish this. So the actual secret use of this move, it's not a super useful move. You can use it to escape corners pretty reliably, just get the opponent in block stun and then boom, out of there. It's got almost no recovery when you land. So you can use it to scoot about the screen sometimes. Or even just wildly. And people looking to punish it by low profiling you, maybe you can just fly over their heads and then you don't get punished. But then again, why are you doing the flip in the first place? Usually just for screen position. I don't know if you know this, Derp, but when you get knocked down in this game, there's a frame or two where you're forced to stand. And Guy has a couple setups where he can do the EX flip. I don't actually. I know he can do it after a normal. You can do the EX flip and then catch them on their forced stand frame. And you can actually loop that. Like that. But you can just anti-air
Can
that
you
with
do anything against it?
Wait, what?
Can you, when you do the EX flip after
No,
you get
you
knocked down?
can't combo anything out of it. They can anti-air you just on reaction. Maybe not. They can do what the actual answer is if you don't have a reversal is just on the first frame you're awake, you do a crouching normal, and then you never have the forced stand frame. But what a lot of people if you have a reversal you can do, like a Ryu's jab uppercut or Guy's EX flip, you could just do that and it'll punish it. So it's ultimately it's okay, but it can be gimmicky depending on what your opponent's options are. That's that move
It
done.
works, fuck it.
Yeah, exactly. Oh yeah, hit me with a focus real fast. Hit me, show me some focusing. Oh, I acted like you focused, but you didn't.
Accidentally.
Armor break. And you can use that to armor break. It's not that great because it can get counter hit, but the X one is fast enough that it usually won't get counter hit. And actually, you can cancel into it for an extra reliable armor break. Oh. Let's say you read focus real fast. Boom. Not bad. All right, I already talked about super pretty much everything there is to talk about with super. So you combo into it from Bushin Chain, you combo into it from shoulder. You can anti-air with it. There's not a whole lot to it. Ultra One, there aren't that many setups. You can land it off of a focus attack, crumple. You can't juggle into it unless you're in the corner. And there are two main juggle setups. There's a shoulder into FADC, which I dropped. That takes two bars, but shoulders are quite easy to land. You can land this on a crouching opponent. Whereas, what's happening? It's the lag, I swear. Hata. That's one of the main setups. Shoulder into, or EX shoulder into FADC Ultra. You'll have to trust me that that works.
Trust you.
And then the other one, probably get you out of the corner. The other one is Bushin Chain into Ultra. And that works from quite far away now because of the increased range. But you need a cornered opponent for both of those, which is why it's really important for Guy that he gets corners. I can't think of any other way to land Ultra One. You can let off the sickle. Don't forget the sickle. He's a guy combo. Ta 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 ta.
There we go.
That's not bad. So anytime you can land the sickle in corners, you can land Ultra 1 usually because it goes quite far. Ultra 2 is a one-frame command throw, but unfortunately the frame is after the freeze, which means that if you hold up, you can just jump out of it. Hold up for me, Derp. You didn't hold up. Well, at least we get to watch the cool animation. I should have warned you well in advance that I was going to do that. So on reaction to the freeze, I want you to hold up. Oh my god. Yeah. Just hold the up direction. Hold up. There you go. Done. Not bad.
Literally
hold up. So literally, like, yeah, on reaction, you can just jump out of that and then come down with a jumping combo. Guy comes down with Ninja Jump Fierce, I think, for max damage. So it's really only good for punishing things, but it is one frame, which means that it can punish anything up to, like, minus one moves. I'm pretty sure it's one frame. It could be two, but I think it's 0+1. I think it's a one frame grab. And that means reversal, it can punish minus one anything. So, like, if anything's even a little bit unsafe, guy can pick up that punish. So you use it against, like, Dan and stuff. When, like, Dan kicks you, he's minus two. So you can get that reversal ultra, and it'll work. And it's pretty good for that. But also, you can, like, get it after focus attacks. Take my word for it. And you can also get it after red focus attacks. Like, I don't know what guy does for red focus attacks. I guess, like, ta-ta-ta, maybe. I don't know what else. Everything I'm thinking of, like, knocks over. So I guess just, like, there. There's your Ultra 2 setup. Ultra 2 doesn't have a whole lot of setups, though, so people usually run Ultra 1, but Ultra 1 doesn't have a whole lot of setups either, so people usually just don't land Ultra as guy.
Ultra 2 is cooler, though.
Yeah, it is cooler. It also does more damage, but Ultra 1 is far more practical to land in most matches. Ultra double isn't a terrible option for guy, if only because both his ultras are difficult to land. So you might as well pick ultra W and take whichever opportunity you get first. But I would probably pick ultra one in most matchups. Let me think here. What's left? What else is there about guy that I've forgotten? Mix up Santier's recap. All right, let's do this. Basically, a lot of guys' mix up game is between his elbow drop and the pressure it provides. Like a lot of times, you can do a cross up that I just dropped, or from the same distance, like an elbow drop that's not a cross up. And, like, if the opponent's not anti-airing you, one of those is going to work. And it's really difficult to anti-air someone if they're directly above you in the corner, or if you're waking up off the ground. So, like, me jumping from that height, you see how I just got the cross up? And then from that cross up, I could do, like, a Bushin chain into the grab to get you back in the corner. Like, that. That works. And then I could also, from the same range, I could jump an elbow drop and then, like, pick up combos like that. So either way, you end up in the corner, and I can do it again. And I've got a 50-50 between left and right. So that's pretty good for guy. What else is there? Footsies are kind of hard to explain with guy. You can empty cancel really easily with Stand Strong because it's got a really nice hitbox. It goes a lot farther than his fist goes. Actually, it probably just matches his fist. But it picks up deceptively... It picks up deceptively far away, that's the thing. So, like, let's say you're whiffing, like, something dumb, like Stand Hard Kick. If I'm timing my reactions for your whiffs, I can, like, pick up, like, an empty cancel punish. Like, these are riskless for me to go for. Well, that's a bad trait, so not necessarily riskless. But, like, wow, that moves pretty good. Yeah, I'm impressed with guy. There you go. See that? Like, on reaction to a lot of, like, whiff moves, you can do Stand Strong and hit a punish, like a whiff punish. And then you can combo out of whiff punishes with the X shoulder. And then if you're even a little bit close to the corner, timeout. Stop, 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 stop. Go back to where you were.
No.
If you're here. Let me just move you, dude. It'll be fine. If you're even a little close to the corner, guys' combos with EX shoulder will often pick up enough to combo the opponent to the corner. So, like, that would have worked from even farther away than I was. That'll work from, like, mid-screen onwards, that combo.
That ultra did so little.
It's because it's ultra double. That ultra usually doesn't do a whole lot of damage, though, to be honest. If you get a raw connect of it, it'll do a lot, I guess. It'll do a decent amount. It does like 400 something, mid high 400s, which is quite a lot. I guess combos we'll talk about a little bit. Your bread and butter punish combo is guy is gonna start with stand hard kick on a standing opponent, and then you're probably just gonna go into Bushin Chain. So it'd be like stand hard kick, Bushin Chain, and then maybe EX shoulder if you feel like you want the corner carry. You gotta be pretty quick about this. Nice throw. You didn't even get the link. I dropped the shoulder.
You suck.
You suck. You can't even hit the combo. That's not a cancel. You can't cancel Bushin Chain. That works in corners, I think. I think that actually works. I think that's one that actually works. Actually, I'm not sure.
You do suck.
Maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe on large characters.
Yeah, get over here.
Okay.
I just want to see.
And then you get it. Oh, you got to hold down. After the first jab, you can hold down. It doesn't matter.
Nope.
Other guy mix-ups, you can basically just, you basically go for the loops and stuff. You try and get repeated knockdowns into,
trying to get the grab.
Come on, dude. Try to teach people how to play the game. You can practice this on your own time.
Practice whenever I'm on this damn game.
So, oftentimes you can go for a run slide as opposed to a shoulder. Shoulders get a lot more corner carry, but run slide gets wake up mix up, but it's not as valuable anymore. But like you can do those wake up shenanigans and then catch people like trying to do stuff, trying to get free wake ups, and then you can mix it up between empty jump low, empty jump throw, safe jump into like slide, or safe jump into EX Tatsu, depending on what you're expecting. Safe jump into block. So guy can basically get like a lot of stuff like that. That's where a lot of his momentum comes from. I don't know how to show you like what guy's gameplay is supposed to look like. I guess I just tell you to go look up guy, like good guy players. Like there's this Japanese player called Kiryu Tsukimiya. Kiryu Tsukimiya. He's a really good one. I can't think of any other really famous guys. There's like Redman. He's a really good guy player. There's a, isn't there like a guy player, RLBS or something like that, at Next Level Battle Circuit? He's a good guy player. There's a couple American guy players, but I can't think of any right now. Isn't there one at Wednesday Night Fights, dude? I can't think. I'm pretty sure there is, but I can't think of who it is. Pretty sure there's a guy there, though. Mark Teddy. That's him, Mark Teddy. How could I not think of that? Mark Teddy's probably the best guy in America, honestly. RLBS might be better. Yeah. The best guy in the world, I have no idea, but I would probably say Kiryu based on what I see. But it honestly could be one of the American guys. I don't know, I've never seen them play each other. I just said it, dude. Yes. His last name. I wonder if that's actually his name. I doubt it. I don't know what it means. It could be a name.
I've heard of some dude named, like, Densetsu or some shit.
Densetsu. That means legend or something. Whoa, look, that's spooky. Someone posted a spooky dead dog in my stream chat. That's spooky.
That's creepy.
I'm honestly struggling to think of anything else guy does. He's got a close light kick that sucks.
Smug is the best guy, alright.
This might just be a complete guy off the top of my head. Things the guy can do. I didn't talk about his combos enough. So you've got basically two big combos that you go for. No, it's more than that. Let me think. Guy combos. So I was saying, stand hard kick into follow-ups. You can do Bushin Chain. You can do Tart combo, like that. That'll end super easier, I guess, but that I think that does less damage than Bushin Chain into super. You can actually do stand fierce. And then on some characters, you can link far strong after that. It's like a 2-frame link, then a 3-frame link. But that doesn't work on everyone. Works on guy, apparently. Works on big guys. Works like T-Hawk and Bison and stuff like that. And you can do really cool combos with that one. It actually does hella damage compared to most of guys' other combos. I might not have gotten it. No, I got it. With full Ultra 1, that does like over 500. which is not bad. Oh, even with Ultra Double, it does over 500. So that's cool. In terms of confirm combos, you usually do like a couple crouch jabs, and if they're blocking, you'd like walk in and throw them. And then if they weren't blocking, you'd react to whether they were stand blocking or crouch blocking. I mean, if they were standing or crouching when they were getting hit. So you could do like, that's a really common one. Crouch jab, stand strong, stand fierce. And then you can cancel that to shoulder. It's a, I think it's a two-frame link. I just dropped it. Yeah, like that. And you can combo that to super if you want. Or, you know, FADC Ultra if you're on a cornered opponent. And then you could also go crouch jab into Bushin Chain, but that requires a standing opponent. But that works. That works even after, like, three jabs. Which is good. And I remember after Bushin Chain, you can pick up a meterless ultra on corners. So that's pretty useful. Crouch short is better than crouch jab because you actually have to low block it. And it's actually faster. It's not as frame advantage, though. Frame advantage is really useful in and of itself. But you can combo it to itself. And after crouch shorts, you go for crouch short, stand strong, stand fierce, maybe. That works on everyone, I think. And I'm pretty sure that forces stand. I'm dropping it a lot, like that. I did Boosh and Tatsu on accident, but you'd normally go for shoulder, I guess. That's a combo you do. I'm dropping it in lots of different ways. There you go. That's what that combo looks like.
Wait, do you do two or three?
No, I dropped it. It's however many you need, dude. Until you react, basically. There you go, I actually did the combo. But that's kind of hard to do. That's much harder than his jab combos. His jab combos are dramatically easier, but they're not as rewarding. It's stand strong. You gotta stand. But that's like the super high-level guy combo. I just dropped it. Dropped my plink. That's like what you would do if you were like a good guy player.
If you were.
Yeah, I'm not a good guy player.
You were.
I was okay. I wasn't good. I never learned to do this. The fact that I can do this at all, like sometimes, is just a testament to fucking how often I practice with Evil Ears one-frame links, that I can just do guys one-frame links, because it's the same plink. It's medium punch to light punch. Anyway, you could do that. You can do crouch short into stand jab, and that's, I think, a two-frame link. It's kind of hard. It's 3 frames plus 5, and stand jab is a 4-frame move, I think. I could be wrong. So that's like a combo you can do. This is going to be quite hard. His short links are in general like harder than what you otherwise would do. It's he's a stand up. Two crouching moves then standing for the rest of it. If you're not used to that, you're dialing it really fast if you just got hard kick there. Whatever. Practice this on your own time.
When?
What else is there in terms of confirms? I feel like there's more. Stand Fierce can whiff on small opponents from max range, like after like 3 crouch shorts. So if you do like Stand Strong, Stand Fierce, that sometimes will whiff. And I think Light Shoulder will whiff after a distance too, which is kind of annoying. That one still hit, but on a lot of characters that'll whiff. So normally you just go for Stand Strong, and then because Stand Fierce and Shoulder can both whiff, you just do Stand Strong into Run Slide. And Run Slide is his fastest. Like, Hosanto won't combo off of Far Strong, so his only thing combos after a Far Strong is EX Hosanto, which costs meter, or Run Slide, which is free. So Run Slide's like his fastest follow-up to a lot of stuff. And I didn't mention this, but I think Stand Slide can't combo from lights. Yeah. So you need a medium button. And if you want a really easy combo that just works like other characters' combos, you can do crouch short, and then just combo into a Bushin Senpukyaku. And that's pretty easy. You just gotta get the links, but then if you get the links, it's literally just you cancel the last one. I feel like you were close. You can actually link EX Bushin Senpukyaku because it's fast enough. You almost got the link. The link looks like this. I dropped it. I don't have this one either. I've never attempted this combo. I'm just, you know, theoretically it works. But, I don't know, it's harder than it looks. I linked. I wanted to... I canceled the special move, but I wanted to link the special move. Let me get this once. There, I did it.
Yeah, like, so I just did, I was trying to get free crap.
But you want the, you don't want the cancel. Or, I mean, you don't want the link, you want the cancel. So you want to do, like, try just crouch light kick into medium seppukyaku, which would be the version you'd use, because it goes the farthest and does the most damage. Remember, hard doesn't hit. No, just try crouch light kick into medium seppukyaku by itself. Just that. There you go. You want two crouch light kicks into that. Into that little combo. I would understand if you found this quite difficult, though. And that works on crouching opponents, too, which is nice. There's one other very minor couple combos that Guy can do that aren't super important, but I just think they look cool, so I often show them off. On some characters, you can get this flip, not Guy, apparently, but you can get that flip into hard seppukyaku, and that does a massive amount of damage, and you can combo super after it. And then, what else? On a far connect, like here's light seppukyaku, you see how it only got two hits? On far connections, you can pick up a third hit. So it looks like that, for example. You can actually link into that. And if you get all three hits of a Tatsu in the corner, you can actually juggle into a super. And that ends up doing pretty nice damage. If you do like a jump roundhouse, or like a jump fierce into down forward this thing, into hard seppukyaku, on the characters that works on, into super, it does like in the excess of like 650 damage. It's really strong. But of course it costs you super meter and it requires a jump in on a cornered opponent. It's character specific, so, you know, it's not that useful. I can't think of anything else for Guy. There's not a whole lot to this character. I mean, there is a lot to him because he's got a lot of very specialized special moves. But, that was an example of the shoulder whiffing, because the range was too high. That happens. I guess Guy's done. I hope the guy who requested the Guy tutorial enjoys it. Or whatever. Guy's taunts are like the worst of any character in the whole game. Honestly, they all take a super long time.
What the f-
It's, I don't know, dude, some Naruto shit.
Yeah.
Guy's a ninja.
Guy's a badass ninja.
Yeah, okay. Guy play is super matchup dependent, honestly. Guy needs to, Guy does very different stuff depending on the opponent he's fighting. And that's what I was talking about when I said Guy has a lot of highly specialized tools. So I've got to do one of these with Scrafted for Akuma. So I should probably do that right now.
Dr. Shiki would probably enjoy that.
Yeah, he probably would. I'm pretty sure that combo doesn't work. It'd be really cool if it worked. It's a cool looking combo. You can do hard EX Tatsu. You can't do hard Tatsu. EX works though.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's all four hits too, which is probably the best follow-up. But most people usually do, I think, low strong. Or, like, low jab. Okay. So I will see you probably in not so long, Derp, and we'll probably play Street Fighter against each other.
Okay, that works, because I'll be going to work out for a little bit, so...
Alright, cool. Convenient.
Yep. Freaking bully.
Alright, later.
Alright, later.